To you, and I have a beautiful fragrance that I would like to recommend to you today, and I want you to know that I have selected this particular fragrance as my birthday fragrance. And without any further information regarding, I'm gonna let you know that this fragrance speaks for itself, and it's none other than Good Girl. Yes, Good Girl by Mrs. Carolina Herrera. This right here happens to be a 3 ounce. When I decided that I wanted to invest in this fragrance, I knew then that I wanted nothing less than the 3 ounce. And the reason I wanted the 3 ounce, because the 3 ounce symbolizes to me a real size shoe because it's so large. Look at that. Isn't it absolutely adorable? I think it's exceptionally exquisite. This design of this fragrance bottle happens to be one of the most magnificent, amazingly art designed fragrance bottles I think that has ever been created. What a magnificent idea, a magnificent work of art which Miss Carolina Herrera has designed here. I am truly in love with this container. It represents nothing but me. I love my stilettos. As a matter of fact, I have a stiletto identical to this shoe. You may not think so, but I think it's absolutely identical. It's a pair of stilettos that this girl, she used to wear all the time. Yes, I used to be a stiletto queen, and that's why I love this here little stiletto here. And too bad it only comes in one shade. Otherwise, I'll probably try to collect all of them since I'm a fragrance collector. But this here itself, the way it's designed, is so beautiful. Here you have the sprout right here where the fragrance comes out. And on the box, it has here a description showing you exactly how to spray it. You know, when I first opened the container, I didn't see this little example right here of how to do it. The instructions, actually, they're considered instructions of how to spray the container, because the smaller ones are totally different. I think with the smaller ones, like the 2.5 and the 1 ounce and the 2.5 ounce and all of that, I think it comes out back here where you, I don't know, I think the back part comes off, because I remember giving that as a gift to someone previously, and the back part I think comes off. It like screws off or something, or it sprays out of here. But this one, I was almost about to break the heel because I was like, oh, I thought you pressed that and it come out. But no, you press right here on the back of the shoe itself. Gently now, gently, because you don't want to break this here, the heel. You don't want to break this, because this feels like it's made out of plastic, but I love the overall patent leather. It's a glass bottle, but it looks like patent leather. It looks just like the heel of my shoe here, patent leather. And you spray it like this, gently. If I'm not mistaken, yeah. Let's get this baby out of here. Whoop, there we go. Honey, I love this fragrance. I just love this fragrance. It's one of the most beautifully, exquisitely smelling fragrances I've smelled in quite some time. As a matter of fact, this one has been designated as one of my signature scents as well, because I am truly in love with this fragrance as well. I'm gonna put some more on so I can smell like this all day long. I don't wear it often, but I am truly in love with, I'm trying to make sure I smell it well. And let me tell you, this fragrance right here, as I stated before, is an EDP. It's an EDP fragrance, not an EDT, but an EDP. With this aroma, you have such a gourmand scent applied to this fragrance. But not only that, you get this tropical and this subtropical and this Mediterranean vibe floating from this fragrance. It's an aroma that's highlighted by a bouquet of fragrance, sweet, bitter, and powdery aromas, all contributing at the same time toward the development of this here scent. Oh, it's so lovely. You can, oh my God, it's so sweet. It's sweet, but yet it's bitter and it's powdery and it's unique. It's so indifferent from anything I have ever smelled before. And I truly, truly, truly believe that the tones in here are what set this fragrance aside from anything I've ever smelled before, because the notes are lined in such a major perfected manner to the point where you will not be able to deny the loveliness which has been applied to this fragrance. This fragrance come to you with a gourmand scent, but yet a bitter, a twist of sweet, and everything all twisted up together. And when it dries down, you get the elevation of the vanilla. Oh yes, and it has a vanilla twist to it. And it's very comforting, and it's a very comforting scent. But let me explain to you, honey, you have some very, very alluring notes in this fragrance. This fragrance consists of top notes that are consisting of predominantly almond and coffee beans. Almond and coffee beans, which grant it that gourmand scent. And it's so beautifully, ooh, it's so beautifully scented. So beautifully scented to where it's, you would just find it so uniquely different from anything you've ever smelled before, because I do, and I truly love it, because with the gourmand scent that's applied in here, it also grants it at the same time a lovely amount of spiciness. Yes, and that spiciness is so appealing, definitely. Oh my God, it's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. Then you go on over to your middle notes, and your middle notes consist of an excessive amount of jasmine and the tuberose and orris, which grants it the smell of white flowers, which grants you that floral scent, which you will obtain from this as well. Yes, it has a hint of floral aromas within it. And then you go on into your base notes, which consists of an exceptional amount of tonka beans and vanilla and sandalwood, yet alone it comes with a little bit of coconut in here, which all contributes to the wood, the oud scent that you attain from this. It all contributes to that, which makes it smell so much more lovely and appealing toward the nose, the senses. And it's comforting from the bitter notes in here. It grants you a great deal of comforting, which it has an exceptional amount of balsamic aroma applied in here as well, which also, as you all know, consists of grapes. The grapes has a little bit of twist of scent of balsamic applied to it as well, which, like I said, granted a great deal of comforting, but with your bitter notes also comes a little bit of sensuality. And then you cross on over to your sweet notes, which are going to give you that pleasing aroma, because you find it very appealing. Yes. Oh, and the powder is here is elevating itself, and everything's aligned so beautifully to the point the powdery gives it that gentle, soft, delicate texture that you're going to attain from this fragrance, because everything is exceptionally potent as it elevates itself. But then as it began to dry down, like I said, you receive a little bit of that balsamic, the bitterness and the sweetness and all of those elements originating themselves together, but yet and still you're going to have that wood element, which also consists of the spiciness. So you get a warm, spicy, inviting appeal from this fragrance as well. It has so much going on in it to the point where it's very attractive. It has a contribution toward the scent as a whole, and it's all functioning so lovely and so adequately. Everything's being distributed perfecto, in a perfected manner. It's perfection at its most. With this particular fragrance, so Mrs. Carolina Herrera, I just want you to know that with the garment notes you have in here, the woodiness and the vanilla and the sweet pottery elements and everything, you have given us this warm, this spicy, this inviting, this comforting, this here pleasing fragrance, which I highly, highly, highly admire. And that's why I have selected this as my birthday fragrance for this particular year, which will be worn all day long on my birthday. Yes, I haven't ever selected myself a specific fragrance to wear on a birthday all day long, meaning that I have been collecting fragrances for a long time, but this is my first year ever selecting a fragrance as my birthday fragrance. And I just want all of you viewers to recognize that this here happens to be it. And I highly recommend Miss Carolina Herrera Good Girl to all you girls out there to select this particular fragrance as, if not your birthday fragrance, at least to your collection. Add this fragrance to your collection as if for no other reason as a beautiful container to set on your vanity or just to possess. I just want you to know that it's beautiful from the scent to the magnificent design of this container, honey. You will never be disappointed, because even when the fragrance gone, you have something lovely and beautiful and attractive to admire forever and ever and ever in a day. So I highly recommend Miss Carolina Herrera Good Girl to you. And I thank you so much for tuning into my channel, and you have a wonderful evening.